You've now learned what Azure SQL Edge is and some of the use cases and the reference architectures. In this video, you'll dive deeper into actually how it works and take a look at a demo this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. I'm joined once again by Vasia, a program manager on the Azure SQL SQL Server team. Thanks for being with us again today.
It's a pleasure to be here, Anna.
Awesome. And in our previous videos, you know, we've talked about what is Azure SQL Edge, and we talked about some of the use cases and some of the architectures. And now I'm really excited because you're going to show us what it actually looks like and some of the things we can do with it. So can you tell us, like, what are you going to show us?
So I'm actually going to show how to use Azure SQL Edge in a wind farm. It's essentially helping wind turbine operators to understand if something's going wrong and if electricity is not being generated properly. So what we have for the purpose of this demo, let us assume that we are the operators of the Contoso wind farm. And what we have in front of us is a dashboard, which represents the turbines on this wind farm. So the central unit of each of these turbines has an Azure SQL Edge instance running on them. The Edge instance is actually collecting data from multiple sensors located in the different components or parts of the wind turbine. So these sensors measure various aspects that could affect the wind turbine, such as wind speed, wind direction, oil temperature, et cetera. Additionally, data from each of these sensors is streamed to the Azure SQL Edge for processing and ML inferencing. Data from each of these instances is further aggregated and uploaded to a cloud target. And in the case of this video, for this demo, the cloud target is actually an Azure Blob storage. This is essential for long-term retention and ML model training. So as you can see over here, an issue has been identified with unit 34, and we need to figure out what's actually happening over there. We are running a query to understand what's going on. At an immediate look over here, we find that there's like a surge in the power that's being generated by this particular wind turbine. But when we look at the vibration, the oil temperature, or if any parts are failed of the fire, none of that is actually happening. It's just power generation. And you see this pane over here called security alert, but it doesn't show, it shows that none of the events are visible to us. That's because we are an operator and not a security engineer. So what's in play over here is the security feature of SQL Engine, which is role-based access control. So only security engineers can have a look at what's happening in terms of security. So let's look at environmental factors. So on our left side, we have the wind speed and the wind direction of the farm. And both seem to be pretty stable for the wind farm as a whole. But then when you look at the right side, which is for this particular turbine, we see a lot of turbulence in the wind speed and the wind direction. So this creates a lot of deviation, and that's why the power generation is not happening properly as expected. So what we are going to do now is actually look first, see this data that we already have. There is some issue happening over here. We need to take that data from blob storage, run an ML model, train it, and deploy it again onto our turbine to see to correct the issue. So let's look at our ML Studio. What we have over here is a Jupyter notebook that we are going to use for training the ML model. First and foremost, we'll be setting up our Azure ML workspace, and next is where we'll be fetching our data. So data here is actually fetched from our Azure Blob Storage container that I initially mentioned, where we are storing all of our data from the wind turbines. Once we fetch our data, we just collected a subset to see if we are getting all of the details that we need. And looking at it, we are getting the details. And the next thing that we are going to do is actually check if we have enough amount of data to train an ML model. So when you look at the count over here, it says approximately 8,000 records. This is good enough for training our model. Next, let's just have a look at how the wind speed and wind direction is going based on the data that is there. So when you look over here, there is an anomaly for R43, which is there is a whenever the wind direction angle is at 50, that's when there is a spike in the turbine wind distribution. So if we keep going down, we have something called as alter blades. When we say alter blades, it means essentially restarting the wind turbine, or in, that is essentially altering the blades. And once the alter blades are true, that's when the wind direction angle is at 50. From the data, what we can see over here is, yes, the wind direction angle is at 50 and there is some issues with the speed, and therefore it needs to be changed. There are a few more graphs over here that we are currently using. So what we see over here is whenever the wind direction angle is at 50 degrees, that's when the turbine wind direction gets turbulent. There's a huge spike over here, and that's exactly the place where we also see that the alter blades need to become true. And when we say alter blades, that means that the direction in which the turbine is moving, that needs to be altered. We also do carry out further analysis in terms of what is the average wind distribution, what is the wind speed, and what we can see over here is another measurement of standard deviation, which again spikes. Every time there's a spike is when power generation drops. So what we're going to do based off of looking at these graphs is essentially create an experiment. So we will be creating and running an ML experiment. And the process of creating and running an ML experiment takes about 5 to 10 minutes. But in the interest of time over here, I'm going to use an already run ML experiment and take the SAS URL from this experiment and put it in our sensor module twin. So let's go ahead and do that. So we'll be generating a SAS URL. Let's copy this. So when it comes to deploying Azure SQL Edge through IoT Edge and IoT Hub, we use something called as module twins. And when we say a module identity twin, what happens here is this is a replica of the sensor that is already there on your wind turbine that's created over here. And when we paste the SAS URL in this particular place, what happens is the trained ML model that was being stored in our blob storage is now being saved into this module twin. And as you can see that it's been a success. And when we go back over here and hit refresh, you will see that the wind speed of the turbine and the wind direction has been rectified. And therefore, the power is now being generated as required. So with that, we are at the end of the demo, which talks about leveraging how to leverage Azure SQL Edge in a wind farm. So as we have been discussing in the past couple of videos, what I can say is Azure SQL Edge simplifies edge architecture and IoT application development for customers by supplying a small footprint data engine that runs on a choice of platforms, Intel or AMD 64 architecture or ARM 64 architecture, and delivers consistency in data, tooling, and security from edge to the cloud. It's powerful enough to run offline, but with the capability to connect seamlessly to a broader network of services. Azure SQL Edge also includes built-in ML capabilities, support for time series data, and native data synchronization with SQL Server, Azure services such as SQL Database, etc. So, and finally, with Azure SQL Edge, customers have a small but powerful data engine that meets the challenges of IoT, which empowers businesses to use and analyze data collected at the network edge to save costs, drive innovation, improve safety, and gain competitive advantage. What you see here are a list of additional resources to learn more about Azure SQL Edge.
Thanks, Vasia. That was a really powerful demo. I really like the way you took us from end to end, you know, where we're analyzing and monitoring our wind farm and we see there's an issue. We are able to look at the data kind of almost on the fly of what's happening down at the edge. And then we actually went and you retrained a model and that was in Azure, and then you deployed it back to the edge. So really powerful kind of end-to-end story of what's possible with Azure SQL Edge. So just, I really thank you for coming out on the show.
Thank you so much, Anna, and to our viewers over here, Azure SQL Edge is currently in public preview, so please feel free to go ahead, download the bits, and test it out for your various scenarios. You can definitely reach out to us through one of the links provided, which I believe will be provided in this video in the description links. Thank you so much for having me here, Anna.
Awesome. Yeah. So we hope you check it out. And if you like this video, please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and let us know what you're doing with Azure SQL Edge. Thanks for joining us on Data Exposed.